It is good to have a special guest with us today. Brian Blake, who is the president of Georgia State University, is here and doing a good job for us at Georgia State. And he's got his family with us. And I recognize the secretary to read the resolution first.
Senate Resolution 672 by Senator Anderson of the 43rd and others, a resolution recognizing and commending Dr. M. Brian Blake and for other purposes. Whereas, as the 8th president of Georgia State University, Dr. Brian Blake leads the state of Georgia's largest university spanning 6 campuses and 53,000 students. Before coming to Georgia State University, he had over 22 years of faculty and administrative experience across 5 comprehensive research universities, and he has a Bachelor of Electrical Engineering from Georgia Institute of Technology, a Master of Science in Electrical Engineering from Mercer University, and a PhD in Software Engineering from George Mason University. Now, therefore, be resolved by the Senate that the members of this body recognize and commend Dr. M. Brian Blake, and thank him for his efficient, effective, unselfish, and dedicated public service to the state of Georgia, and extend the most sincere best wishes for continued health and happiness. That completes the order, Mr. President.
Is there objection to the adoption of the resolution? Chair hears none, and the resolution is adopted. I recognize the senator from Conyers, Georgia, to introduce our special guest.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good morning, colleagues. I am more than excited to present to you, Dr. Blake. Most of you know that I'm an HBCU grad, but my upper degree, one of them, came from Georgia State. Under the direction of our new president, Dr. Blake, the first black president after 120 years in the history of Georgia State. This is an honor for me. His track record, of course, precedes him, and he has earned every accolade, he has earned every hoorah, he has earned every part of where Georgia State is right now. As he serves on many boards, the Grady Memorial Hospital Corporation, Metro Atlanta Chamber, Junior Achievement of Georgia, and the Atlanta Convention and Visitors Bureau, Dr. Blake has been included on the 2022 and 2023 lists of Georgia 500, the most influential leaders, as well as recognized as the 2023 most admired CEO. He is joined today. He's a native of Georgia. He's Savannah, from Savannah, Georgia. He has attended Benedictine Military Academy. He's with his wife, Bridget, one of his sons, and his father, to celebrate this moment. Thank you, Dr. Blake, for being here with us, and please give us a few words.
Thank you so much, Senator Anderson. I really appreciate being here today. It's such a privilege and honor to be in front of this chamber. She introduced our family, but let me first thank my lovely wife, who's here, Dr. Bridget Blake. She's the best doctor in our household, so Dr. Bridget's here. I owe everything to her, so I'm just so happy she's able to join me here today. My father, the senior M. Blake, is here as well, Malworth Blake. And my son, my youngest son, Bryce, also joins us today, and he's very happy to be out of school. So so let me thank Lieutenant Governor Burke Jones, who actually has been such a supporter through his time and before. Senator Anderson, who gave such a great introduction as an alumna of Georgia State and just been a great role model for our students, and did a fabulous job this year in the Veterans Day. So, and then all the members of this distinguished body, I'm really thankful to be in front of you today. Just profoundly grateful and humbled to get this. And many of you know I'm a native of Georgia, so getting to serve as president is just a dream come true for me, and one that I take a lot of pride in having. It's not just an honor for me, it's a testament for the collective efforts of our faculty, our administration, our students and staff that I'm privileged to both lead and serve. I'm incredibly proud that GSU, as an institution, we for 110 years or more, we've been actually providing economic growth to the state of Georgia. We have the largest body of students that graduate, and we place 9 out of 10 of them right in Georgia. So I'm so happy for us to provide that sort of boost to the workforce. Today, I'm also proud to have two of our dynamic students. I think they're here somewhere. I don't see them, but our current SGA president and rising junior political science major, Xavion Shepherd's here, and we also have the SGA president. Oh, there they go. And also James Wilson, he's our incoming SGA president and rising senior. So I'll just say along the way, it's been, you know, for me, I have a lot of gratitude to this body for your support of public higher education. Our Chancellor Sonny Perdue and his leadership and his support of myself as a president and the 26 other presidents in the university system of Georgia, we're just grateful to kind of be able to serve. So I think there's so many others I could thank as a part of this chamber. I had 3 minutes. I think I'm right at it. So thanks again for having me here, and go Panthers.
All right, good job. All right.